Authorities at the Malaba border have intensified the monkeypox mpox screening to deter cross-border virus spread. Since some cases have also been registered in neighboring Kenya, truck drivers, travelers, and immigrants were subjected to a thorough mpox screening while observing health protocols. Chodrick Okula, the nursing officer in charge of the Malaba Border Post, says that the exercise is being conducted both night and day to ensure no truck driver or traveler misses the screening. They are also conducting tuberculosis TB test and HIV/AIDS, COVID-19 test and vaccinations.
Ideally, we are positioned in a space where we are able to screen all the travelers, including the drivers, all the travelers coming from Kenya through Malaba. We screen them. Those whom we suspect are isolated.
Across the neighboring Malaba-Kenya border point, the mpox screening is also being intensified. Paul Chibi, the manager of Malaba-Kenya Port Health, says they are well equipped to handle mpox patient.
We have a sport health department. We have heightened our surveillance measures to see that cases or suspects we are able to pick at our border point and be able to handle them from there.
Anifa Nangobi, a Ugandan living in neighboring Kenya, expressed gratitude for the exercise.
Checking about our health, which is not very bad, it's good.
With the third term of schools opening at the corner, a group of FDC members who are battling the charges of terrorism have expressed their anger to the Nakawa High Court through their defense lawyer, saying that their children might fail to go to school because their ATM cards are still being held by security operatives. The suspects were appearing before Justice Andrew Katurubuki, who was sitting in for Justice Erias Kakoza, currently on leave. Meanwhile, some of the suspects appeared ill, with some coughing repeatedly, gesturing the need for medical attention. The judge adjourned the hearing for 15 minutes and later resumed the session, ordering that the state return the ATM bank cards to the suspects, and he further ordered that the six suspects be given immediate medical attention.
The prayers regard the right of medical examination of their chosen, enabling their choose to access their phones, IDs, passports, as well as ATM machines. It's true that even when their choose are on remand in prison, they continue to enjoy and or are even entitled to various rights, including but not limited the access to medical care attention. Their choose ought to be examined, and if found to suffer any ailment, must be afforded medical attention by the state.
The defense lawyers welcomed the court's judgment. U.S. President Joe Biden, U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris, and former U.S. President Donald Trump attended a remembrance ceremony in New York on the 23rd anniversary of September 11, 2001. Kamala Harris and Donald Trump shook hands yesterday at the New York 9/11 Memorial to mark the anniversary of the attack hours after they clashed in a combustible TV debate. Biden looked on as Harris and Trump greeted each other again, with all three wearing blue commemorative ribbons. They watched as the names of the almost 3,000 victims of the attacks were read out. During the debate, the Democratic vice president delivered a strong performance against her Republican rival, most analysts said, as the two head towards the November election neck and neck in the polls. Both candidates declared victory after coming face-to-face for the first time on the biggest night so far of the campaign, although any major shift in support may be unlikely.
You make a big deal out of something. I couldn't care less. Whatever she wants to be is okay with me.
But those were your words, so I'm asking.
I don't know. I mean, all I can say is I read where she was not black, that she put out, and I'll say that. And then I read that she was black. And that's okay. Either one was okay with me. That's up to her.
I mean, honestly, I think it's a tragedy that we have someone who wants to be president who has consistently, over the course of his career, attempted to use race to divide the American people.
Harris heads Thursday to North Carolina, one of a handful of states expected to decide the election, where she has erased a 6-point Trump lead to draw level. Trump is due on stage in Tucson, Arizona on Thursday, focusing on our struggling economy and the rising cost of housing.